Yes, hello everybody, what's going on here is special for you Indonesian language for foreigners. Yes, I'm foreigner, I'm Russian, yes, and I'm guru in the Indonesia maybe, or not, but I know that the most coolest way to learn something is to teach somebody. And is one of the best way to improve your knowledges. Yes, and we will do it right now. Lesson number 3 is about our storytelling. Storytelling verbs, storytelling adjectives, storytelling nouns, and storytelling prepositions. Okay, we're gonna speak about it. It's easy, and it's really after this lesson you will know how to create story in the Indonesian language. Need to only improve your vocabulary, and that's all. And you can create every story what you want. Okay, let's learn it. If you are Indonesian, have fun. Okay, next, what we will talk about first is our verbs. All you can find in the description below. Okay, next is our prepositions and our smallest nouns, because nouns you choose for yourself, but main, common using. What should we feel when we tell a story? We can feel, yes, something. Yes, and first verb will be to feel, is merasakan. Merasakan, first verb, let's do like this. Yes, first verb will be merasakan. Merasakan, to feel. In the description below you can find. Next, berjalan, to walk, because our character can walk in. Berjalan. Yeah? Atau tidak, yes or not. Yeah, atau tidak is yes or not. Menceritakan, to tell. When we tell a story, we use this verb, yes? I tell about it. Or maybe our character tell about something for other person, yes? It's like say. Say is berbicara. Next, melakukan. Melakukan is do something. Do. When we use our tool and boom, 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 hammer, and all will be nice. Yes, melakukan. In the Russian is so funny word. Menjadi. Menjadi. To be. To be here. Yes, okay, let's do it. Normally, menjadi is for our to be here. Yes, menjadi di sini. Di sini is here. Di sini. Mencari, to find treasure. Yes, to find treasure. Need to go from the challenges and other things. Next thing, mulai start, yes, and selesai is finish, or we can also use menyelesaikan, to finish, but I use selesai is finished. Okay, you can use menyelesaikan, it's all what Google translate about. Seperti, next, it will be prepositions really useful. I use that, these two, every day and every moment. But first, seperti, you know that really enemy word, really trash word in the every person who under than 14 in the English countries is like that. Yeah, you know. And for being like this treasure and trash man in the Indonesia, use seperti, and you will be like yes, if you want to compare something, use seperti. Next, dengan, if we have friends like teman is friend in the Bahasa Indonesia, we have teman, yeah. And how to remember is, I don't know how, but I know how to remember it. In the Russian, we have verb called like a dergat. Dergat is when we pump, for me, pull, yeah? And dengan means that we, with this person, connection. And how I remember tentang, we have tentacle. Do you know what is tentacle? Tentacle. One moment, how it will be on the your language.
Tentacle.
Tentacle. Tentacle is some of the on the asminok. Asminok is octopus.
Octopus.
Octopus. Octopus have tentacle. Is some of the, this thing. And tentang, when we talk about it, we have one thing, and we have tentang, we talk about this. Cool? Yeah. Cerita. Next, we're content with nouns. Cerita is story, because we're talking about story. Kami, we. Kami, or. Atau, or. Saya. Menceritakan cerita. Menceritakan cerita. Here. Cerita. Cerita. Story. Yeah? Understand how it looks like. It's like a math. Math class. Fifth grade. Sebuah character is a character. In the Russia, I don't know. It's really a character. It means that we have some traits and also we have some of the character. Character who do actions. I think that is maybe about traits, but I don't know. Okay, we'll use it for character. Next, seorang musuh, an enemy. Enemy. Seorang. Seorang means... and sebuah, I think that is maybe traits, because we have sebuah. Sebuah is for an alive person. And seorang is for people who looks like people. Because orang is man. Orang, man, woman, or human. Yes? People. Seorang musuh, an enemy. Because we have our main character, main hero, and we have our seorang musuh. Musuh. Yeah? And also, we have sebuah harta karun. Karun. It means that a treasure, because we want to find treasure. It's like a cycle of the our adventure. We have cycle of the adventure. Maybe other cycle. We have character who have some of the first our setup. Yes. Next conflict. Next some of the things, challenges, other enemies. Yes, and some of the friendly person. Next. And we have some of the culmination moment. And after that, we have our conclusion. And in the conclusion of our cycle, we should be on the our round. We should be more powerful, more kaut. Kaut is strong in the Indonesia. Yes, kaut, or how to say it. Quad is strong, more strongly, more powerful we should be. And all you can find in the description below. I hope that I help for you, and else I help for yourself. Yes, because I was learning more cooler, and I hope you too. Because no need to waste your time with watching some of the memes or maybe some of the Instagram stories and how other people do. Create yourself and improve yourself daily. Develop yourself, you can. Yeah, thanks so much for watching. I hope you was enjoyed, and sorry if I may be wrong. If you are Indonesian people, write in the comment section what was wrong and we will correct it. And don't forget to read in comment section too if you are not Indonesian person, because it will improve more and more. And I hope that I will be fluent in the Indonesian, and you will be too. Thanks so much. See you in the next time. Bye.